G'day guys, welcome to match 2 in round 2 between the European Gentleman, Nat Nat and Roma the Beast, Duel USA, up against Axis, Omega CLS, Flapperjack, and Liam, Flapperjack Finland, Liam as Germany, here at Dead Center, for hopefully will be an absolute cracking game, as the replay says and states. So we're looking forward to this. We have Liam going to the center with the MG call, and a total, evasion of the center by the other team. Nat Nat taking advantage of it, sending a Marksman Jaeger all the way to the spawn area, and it's going to catch. Huh? So Flapperjack. Oh, this is going to confuse the hell out of me. This is actually Flapperjack, guys. With Nat Nat's icon. Stupid buggy replays. Western and Northern Point, we have Remember the Beast going there uncontested with the Elite Marksman Rangers, all of them sent in one go. Oh no, one grenade could change that. Oh, why isn't there fire? Why aren't they firing? Oh, they are now, and they have easily taken that point, though lost the center entirely, and their spawn flag. So Ranger squad from Nat Nat now going to chase off the Elite Marksman and the Flapperjacks, who are now in the gully. Wow, interesting engagement in the shootout from far range. I dare say the Rangers will win, but it doesn't look like at this stage. They are kind of winning. But here's the Elite MG of Liam going to come up in the flank, perhaps. Oh, nasty. This is awesome infantry gameplay at the moment. Flapperjack and Liam tag teaming Nat Nat. Got the right word eventually. Flapperjack coming with a Marksman Jaeger. This is brilliant. And have really wiped out the Ranger squad. But here is a regular squad from Nat Nat. The firepower is too much. Marksman Jaeger's fuel them perish. Two left. And Elite MG is going to reposition into safety behind this wall, because it's going to try to flank this guy. Not going to do too much. A bit too far. Ranger's being pushed up a bit forward now from Roma the Beast to consolidate position. We're Southern Point. Being held by a few lowly riflemen from Nat Nat. Now is being assaulted by a full assault squad from Flapperjack. The Somi SMG should have no problems dispatching those two, already pinning down the remaining. The rest will start flanking. This is a Flapperjack, remember guys, with the Nat Nat's icon. Just got to remember. Axis is Team Omega CLS. Center, Nat Nat even building some sandbags on his spawn flag. And still not opting for the center point. So 8-0 lead for Omega CLS because of the center push. Kind of cutting them off, but the Rangers are on their own pretty much in that area. And in between them, absolutely nothing. Clear way, but right now they're going to change that with conscripts. just conscripts. SMG, that's a perfect nom-nom material for that MG42 already. Wow, look at the firepower in that beast. Accuracy and firepower because it's with the Panzergrenadier. These conscripts get even mowed down from far range. Reload on the MG42, and they've actually gone beyond before. It's going to be quite hard to hit now. Another elite. Oh, this MG guy has picked up. So this is the SDG44 from the assault squad leader. Takes out two rangers with a grenade. Doing very well at this stage. Right side, the rangers are even getting flanked by the Sony SMG. Two left. And a few MGs at the back, holding on very well with just SMG guys coming in with a reservist squad with some meat, should support well. Wow, this SMG is doing very well to hold this position. Marauders out, shotgunners, and some, you can say Thompson 1919, I think it's a fictional gun with a huge ammunition clip. M20 Sherman from, M10-20. Light vehicle from Nat Nat. I think it may not want to venture there, it's too strong, but it's going to venture to the right. Panzer Faust from the assault squad leader takes out the M20! Flapperjack! Whoa, this assault squad's been the best buy ever on this point, holding strong against Rangers, against the Marauder squad, which can't really do too well in the open shootout. Shotgunners can only work close. Oh, he's going to blow away the M20 with. Oh no, I think you can still pick up the stuff inside. The entity, I don't know if you can actually. No, perhaps you can't now. Well, there's a bazooka in there, and also the 50 cal to pick up. Doesn't matter anyway. Flak 38 in position now. We'll be able to pick off everyone. Nat Nat decides to sneak the Marauders away. Shotgun is not in a great position as Flapperjack with Nat's icon is moving Flak 38 to the center, middle of center. Though in this map it can't really cover two flags, as this hill right here will prevent that. Unless you probably put it down here or something, it can probably cover a bit. Still at counter from Nat. Flapperjack very, very wise, or very quick thinking for him to move it away. Probably heard it or saw it in the background. Now, not being able to be shot by that Stuart. Now Stuart is able to support and will take out the remaining of the assault squad troops. Now, nice move from the reservist Flapperjack, pushing into a very open area of the enemy. We'll be able to spot and also cause some havoc. Stuart moving to the far edge of the map. Now clearing the point. Marauders have now come in to cap the point. Meryl's Marauders, their full name. Added in one of the last patches of the World at War. Option for USA to have some close range fast attacking troops instead of the 30 cal shootout spam. Bam. HSM takes it a few. So it should hold on strong, but we do have a P3 or Panzer 4 JJJ. Bleh. Excuse me, guys, we've had a total moment of stutter. Panzer G, Flapperjack. The hell's a campfire there? Very nice. And it's, what is it? What are they cooking? Chicken. Ooh. This guy's not hungry. This guy isn't hungry either. They don't like chicken in Finland. Stuart. In a decent position to 50-50 the Panzer G. Flapperjack wise to move away, which he is. Though also that Flak 38 will be in a good position to flank the Stuart if it tries to go too much forward. I think it's still in a decent position to go 50-50. It's quite... Well, that actually has Flapperjack's icon, so it's a bit of a switch. Interesting. So Flapperjack moving his G back. Reservist from Flapperjack coming in. Nat with the Stuart pulling back a bit. I think the G is with outside the grasps of the penetration. Well, that Stuart. Nice push up from Roma. Takes it a few frontal troops from Roma, and really nothing on the western northern point for Axis. They're slowly also putting some line of sight behind cover, behind the lines. You have a bit of a gap on this side though for the allies. Now coming in with the Marine squad from Nat. Center has kind of been whittled away a bit, I'm not sure how. You have reconnaissance out there right from Roma. Also veteran sniper from Liam should be able to do some work in the center. A bit of awkward positioning with the gravestones here. Can potentially only fire that, but is struggling to actually take that guy out too. You can see the scope just flashing, not wanting to shoot. No, still quite awkward. You can see. Oh no, it's taking a shot. Liam sneaking the Marines up. This side you have the Stuart's been taken out somehow. G's now moving in and coming back to Flapperjack. Should take that back for Team Omega CLS. Flapperjack moving his Flak 38 to the center perhaps. Marines plus the airborne squad. Interesting graph from that mixing the third tier in. Here is the Panzer Grenadiers from Liam, 4 tier core. Two MG42s will definitely do well. Though that M4A1 carbine is actually doing some work on these Panzer Grenadiers. In a shootout at this range, perhaps they might win. The SDGs and the MG42 is not doing too well in a range shootout. Though they have no cover on the other side, and I think they looks like the USA might lose in the shootout at the moment. Some flanking maneuvers from Roma the Beast of Conscripts. One guy even venturing beyond next to spawn, but has been spotted and will be taken out by the MG. No, doesn't. The MG42 Brandenburger has other ideas. Shooting still at the Marines in the center. Marines surviving quite long, but here's the flak will pretty much change the entire battlefield, and the airborne will have no chance now. Croc in the back. Struggling to get some line of sight in that. Pushing up a bit more. It's gonna go to the western, north. Got a half track going to the southern east. Panzer G's there though, waiting for it. Reservists. swinging. So 24 to 11. Decent lead from a mega CLS. Here comes the half track. This is mechanized. Elite mechanized squad. Oh, sniper. Ooh, it doesn't pick off the driver. Too fast. Where that sniper's back over here. It's the White Death. But he's the half track doing well. G is moving up. And there is no croc in sight. But dangerous. But that Panther. Ooh, Bazooka has just missed a shot. Too bad it's not a Piat. Oh, recoilless rifle. Well, I was going to say too bad it's not a Piat, but doesn't matter. Too bad it isn't a Piat for Flapperjack, because the recoilless rifle has the range to take it out from this one. And that you never know, those half-track buyers do make it to us sometimes. If they come at the right time, there's no 20 mil in the area. And in a situation like that, yeah, certainly what he needs. That range and the recoilless rifle, getting the Panzer G with its pants down and with no support. The half-track mowing down everything now. White Death forced to relocate, running away back to a far position where it can't be touched. A center has his axis as expected. I missed that. The croc has died to something. Must have been a Panzer Grenadier, Panzer Faust or something, or Panzer Shrek. Northern point, we've got a sneaky Roam of the Beast conscript. Will potentially provide line of sight in the future on spawn. So I think Omega is going to try and make a push for the other side. Got a sniper being repositioned behind a stone wall. Going to pick off the rangers bit by bit, perhaps. Boom, one down. A few more to go. And also some elite marksmen, Panzer Grenadiers on the outliers. That can swing to the right. Croc still repairable. Roam of the Beast is repairing it. So Liam still has his Panzer Grenadiers on the point. Flak, I think the Flak has perished, must have been from that croc. I think you should want to finish that off, looks like he will try. Hard track still doing some work in the southern eastern. Flak by again from Flapperjack. Liam now trying to shoot the tank crew, not having much luck, so probably just run up there and take him out. Throw a grenade, get the dynamite out. Happy days. Rangers coming from that. Seeing a lot of 4th tier squads in this game. Very cool to see, proving to be useless. 20mm haven't been the norm to spam, I guess, in most of these top tier games. Elite tier are the go-to for a lot of situations, which is cool to see. A testament to my balancing skills, by the way. Veteran sniper. Awkward position to shoot the guys here, though. Yeah, I'm not sure. I guess it can only take out down here. Can't really shoot well down here. Need a sandbag right here or something. MG34, MG42, and some more Panzer Grenadiers with MG42s and STG44s. Really both teams spamming it out, spamming these units. Rangers versus Panzer Grenadiers. I dare say Panzer Grenadiers will win, but they are more expensive. The longer range, Rangers will have a bit more of a bit more chance. They probably will still lose out. But the AT weaponry definitely goes to the Rangers with the recoilless rifle. And the price also goes to the Rangers with the price cost MP-wise. Panzer Grenadiers trying to flank and get into that position. That's going to be good, but no, says the squad here. Takes out two. Panzer Grenadiers, one with the MG-42. Roam of the Beast having in that squad at the right position at the right time. And these guys are going to get overwhelmed. This one MP-40 guy and one with the GA-34. But wow, this MG-42 is just going to flank the entire assault squad. Doesn't matter, one grenade off will take out one perhaps. But this one's going to get torn up and it's going to get outshot. Looks like he's been pinned down, shot up from the side. Real reconnaissance sniper has taken it out. That's cool. He made an impact on the battlefield there. Reconnaissance sniper comes with the aim shot, but doesn't kill in one shot as a normal sniper. It's a semi-sniper, as we like to call it. A nice idea from the Finnish players who had the idea for the unit. Arcturus and Timo. Thanks for that idea. Shout out to them. Realm of the Beast with a B30 cal coming in. So this point hasn't been really contested the whole game, or has tried to be. It hasn't been in danger whatsoever. Infantry wars have been going on here. At the Rangers have been holding with support. M20 now coming in. No vehicles really being rushed by the Axis on that side. Whilst on the southern, we've got Nat-Nat. Is this Nat-Nat? Yeah, Nat-Nat with the... Wow, he's got the Fury and the half-track to get this point back. So it's 29 apiece. Even Stevens, and on the kill board, almost the same. Almost 200 apiece. This game is indeed an absolute cracker. It's close. It's going to go down to the wire. 15 minutes in. Still no advantage from both teams at this stage. Reconnaissance leader with the binoculars. Another great idea by the Finnish players. What the hell is that? Nice explosion takes out a lot of Axis troops. Right side now kind of being pushed quite hard. KV-1 has taken out the toe for the Bofors. This is no normal KV-1, this is the Finnish KV-1, I believe. Is it? Or is it? No, it's Flapperjacks. Which, yeah, it is. It's the Finnish KV-1, obviously, with that sign up top. It's not a swastika, it's what you call it. So it's just part of the Finnish army. With no relation in terms to a Nazi symbol, if I'm not mistaken. Comes with extra armor. Modified KV-1. 5 special points, if I'm not mistaken. Yep. But it is tracked in the center. And potential flanks from that now with the bazooka. He's definitely hunting it. M8's gonna try to get the repair to not happen. With the constant bombardment. Oh! Bazooka knocks out White Death. The White Death is 500 hit points, my friend. It's gonna take a lot more than 2 bazooka shots. It's Simo Hayek. He can take anything. Oh, it's nearly dead when we hit Nat-Nat. Well, Flapperjack is actually quite silly not to notice for so long, and he's been knocked out but still alive. One more shot, that's fuming. He's gonna take one more shot. Can he take out White Death? Oh, he misses! White Death is gonna fall back into the sandbag once again. He's gonna heal up with the... Boom! And it's crashed. GG. Damn it, I have to wait for 17 minutes. Alright guys, I think it's where I crashed. Wait another 17 minutes. Unfortunately, this game crashes too often. Pretty much the last 3 times I've casted, 3 out of 3 games it crashed, so... Interesting. So 76 Fury has everything being thrown against this KV-1. It's not getting damaged at all, but it's been tracked and immobilized, so at least that's a plus. And I think it's out of range for these guys. Vanda's Bazooka! Oh, Bazooka took out White Death, that's what I was watching. So I remember it has taken out White Death. After, 200 shots and Flufferjack didn't notice? Interesting. Why he didn't notice that, oh what? Hang on. Oh, there it is, it's dead. So he's got his own AT guys, right here. So, oops, sorry, I forgot to actually put my headphones on so I don't have sound. I can't, that's why I'm not feeling the immersion. Give me a second. There you go, so Buffers, 76 Fury, everything's being flung against this KV-1. Oh, it's been main gun though. Quite a unique thing to have a kind of indestructible tank from the front, to be honest. Especially USA, when it doesn't have the weaponry for it. Nat-Nat with some more AT infantry, hoping to potentially kill that KV-1. It's been tracked again. Flapperjack with a OT-130 flamethrower. Been tracked by what? I didn't see that, sorry. I was looking at my phone. On the southern eastern, Flapperjack has one Border Jaeger holding it with the MG. Full-on Ranger squad coming in. Let's see how much damage they can do. Ooh, Border Jaeger, here it goes, doesn't kill one, and here comes the firepower of the Ranger squad, now going to slowly pick away this MG who's getting torn up from the side, even though he's behind cover, and he falls to the ground to being shot. Fury in the back from Nat-Nat, also Fury from Roma, so both of them going Fury. Right, so basically you're faster reload and accuracy for the 76, and wow, even the bazooka needs to get into a fantastic angle to kill it. Unfortunately, the KV-1 is so strong. I think it's got 80 armor on the side, if I'm not mistaken, even more. Expensive, and pretty much it's just sitting there, as a CP hog right now for Flapperjack, as its guns damage. All it can do is fire its MG, DT-29, which won't do too much in my opinion. Should be an easy grenade put away for the ally team if they wish. Liam's flak 38 positioned here, forcing the Fury to come down this side to try to take out the 38. Now running in with the rest of his troops, assault squads coming in. Fury with a shot. Wow, what the hell is that? What? Is there a mortar out? Or I don't see any AT mines. Maybe I can't see AT mines when I'm spectating. That does look like AT mines. Oh, sorry, AP mines. The way it exploded, just out of thin air. Or out of the floor, not in the air. Out of the ground. Howitzer M8. Not having much targets. Maybe this MG42. Not doing too well to take it out. Shooting at this area for some reason. Flak 38 has been taken out by the Fury. Right over here. 30-47. European gentlemen are taking the lead at this stage. KV-1 being quite a useless wreck at this stage as well. Rangers. Oh, nice shot from the M8. But most of them were just reservists. That's Fury is in the backfield just waiting for a target. Oh, big boys out. German, veteran Tiger. Definitely tell it's a veteran Tiger. Not the greatest model, I guess, but we thought to make a difference to the normal Tiger by giving it a bit of camo, like it's a veteran of war, knowing what to do with its how to camo tank. Now I'm going to come in to potentially help the KV-1 get repaired. Take out really nothing to take out. There's no big things to take out on the left side, so I'm not sure. Why, it's probably better off going here to face off. Well, there's actually nothing to take out, to be honest. Both Furies are being very, very safe, waiting in the back, one behind a hill, one behind a house. And they're definitely not going to venture out with the Tiger out. So what the Axis need as well in conjunction with the Tiger is a 20mm bait to force the Tucker to force the 76s to come out to take it out. And the Tiger can protect it, but on its own right now, Tiger won't do anything to influence the battlefield at this stage. Just make the 76 go fall behind. And the Allies do have the infantry superiority in terms of numbers and also firepower, it seems. So nothing's gonna, Tiger can't take out the infantry behind cover. Just needs a 20mm or infantry killer. OT-130 should have been worked, or could have been worked in conjunction with the Tiger, and now faces this area all alone with the 76 free to pick this guy off. Tiger moving to the right side. Probably want to take out the Bofors and the M8 in the center. OT-130. Playing a bit of cat and mouse with Fury. Playing quite smart. Can't be shot at this angle. Fury gonna try, go closer. And OT does evade it. Oh, does not evade it. 76 just being able to sneak a shot above the hill, pops the turret. That looks like it can't hit the hull. All the shots seem to be going on the turret. It go drive away. It can. The track's not down, so it can drive away for another day. M8 trying to track it or immobilize it. Fury chasing it once again, but these hills are proving to be a bane. Ranger in the on the bottom. With the bazooka, not a recoilless rifle. Interesting. It must be an elite AT by Kakapatio Jaeger. I should stop calling that. The K squad, 30 infantry for finish. Pushing in. Really not having the best shots. The right Fury is still strong, and look at the amount of airborne soldiers on this point. Not going to be pushed anytime soon from these Panzer Grenadiers. KV-1 has been repaired, and that's good. Now it can actually be of worth and contribute to the battle. And sitting out all in the open to protect the Tiger from any sort of attack, even though the Tiger is extremely strong from any bazooka attack. and any USA tank, to be honest. There's pretty much nothing other than the Pershing or a lucky slugger shot. But always in the favor of the Tiger. Gonna struggle. Center's completely tank dominated by the Axis forces. Liam going to the right, Flapjack staying in the center. But, lacking infantry firepower, or infantry killing firepower. Sherman. Fury trying to take a track shot, or is it trying to fire shot the Tiger's engine? It's trying to fire shot the Tiger's engine. It actually gets a shot off, and it tracked the KV-1 at the same time. Same bullet traveled past the track and hit the engine. Of course, the penetration too far away. Fury is right there, ripe for the shooting for Liam if he wants to. Just doesn't have his focus in the right position. Flapperjack's the one attacking with infantry. Potentially should call out to Liam to say, take a shot at that Sherman, and does not do so in time. Flapperjack also sending his OT-130. Liam has woken up from his slumber. Flapperjack taking out the troop inside the building. Fury gonna try to take a shot at the OT. Tiger needs to get ready to protect it. Ranger up in that building as well. Good shotgun trooper, has an AT grenade, could be deadly. OT-130 has been taken out there by a bazooka from the airborne. Fury scurrying away behind the buildings towards spawn, away from the Tiger, who has maneuvered to quite a dangerous position. Could be a few ambush opportunities for Flapperjack with the AT grenade, perhaps. Nice MG airborne BAR at the very top of that building. Tiger most likely will want to take a shot. Nope. I'm going to try to take this one out first, but doesn't realize potentially it's actually right here, not up here. Both shells doing nothing at this stage. KV-1 has done something, has taken out the Fury on the side shot. Engine damage though on the KV-1. Wow. From that range. And looks like the Sherman may live another day, and it does. Flapperjack has lost the crew inside, it can't fire back, and its hull destroyed and not coming back. Fury lucky to survive that. BAR, top of the building still going strong. Now the Tiger is focused on it. First shot hits the roof. Second one, oh, poof. Falls to the ground, crushes Ryben to the floor. The only person who survived, saying Private Ryan, but didn't survive. Other than Matt Damon, of course. That. The both has popped into the center. Flapperjack, too many. Oh, both has a bit of collateral damage on his own guy. Western Point. Now this OT tank proving to be quite a valuable unit. But never doing as much damage as it should. Has just been taken out by an AT grenade. Not supported too well with infantry. This one shotgun ship is still alive from a long time ago. A bunch of guys just looking at him. Take him out, guys. We're just from the countryside of Finland. What do? They don't farm, right? Finland, how can they farm in the ice? Guess they're, I don't know what they do. How do they... They hunt, I guess. Yeah, the hunters. Well, the hunters will be good shooters. These are... Oh, wow. I would say some... some countries should have better reservists or better conscripts than others, because I think, Finnish conscripts would be better at shooting due to the need for hunting. Shotgunners, nat, gonna try and micro the grenade, knock off this guy. Tank crew off the point to cap, bam, takes him out. So 80-36, considerable lead by the European gentlemen. Omega CLS has the tank domination though with this veteran Tiger. And I don't think the other team has anything. Fury's been taken out as well. Both of them repairable though. Tiger should be looking to finish them off. A perfect easy chance to do so if he wants to. This stage. Definitely the target he should focus on. Doesn't matter, he's going to use the Carpaccio with the dynamite. I don't want to go too close because it might crash. It's going to be a nice explosion from afar. Oh, it's been thrown away by the tank crew. Lucky bastard. This guy lucky. And so saved it, but here comes another one. This is just a normal grenade, I'm guessing. He throws it away again. Wow. That, that guy has quick reflexes. Center being capped by Nat-Nat, the sneaky guy. A few more of the Axis troops coming in. Flapperjack and Liam, both trying to run in to cap the flag. And we'll take it. Western Point has been taken back by allies. So still a majority cap, 84, not long to go for the European gentleman. Airborne. Score-wise, still very even. Both teams are around the mid-400s. That means kill-wise, not flag-wise. So both do have a good chance of winning the game, in my opinion. Resources, they should both have the same. Both is, should be taken out very... oh no, there's one guy there for line of sight, so it should be okay. Awkward shot to make though. Bit of a hill blocking it. HE shell from what? From an M8. Not going to do too much. Maybe track it though. Needs to take out that Fury. Time and time again, we've seen tanks being repaired in tournaments. No matter how good the player is, they sometimes forget to take out tanks that has been, I guess, hull damaged. And repaired again, and coming back to bite them in the ass. Bazooka from Nat-Nat. Ooh, does get taken out by the Summy. Nat-Nat with the airborne guy going to try to pick it up again, but here comes the other guy going to stop that. Fury still being repaired. They did try the dynamite on it, but really the easy option is just to just go AP shell, bam, dead. Oh, nice shot. I guess that was reloading that M8. That, should take this out. Oh, he really wants the dynamite kill on it, perhaps. I don't know. It's repaired. Maybe repaired just at the wrong time. Flapperjack's going to go in. For some reason, Liam doesn't want to use his AP shells. What's it doing? Now it is finally shooting some shells at it. Ooh, Nat-Nat. Oh, it takes out the Tiger. He takes out the Tiger's gun and destroys it. Oh, that is painful to watch. The dynamite could have killed it. That guy nearly killed it. And this Tiger just decides to waltz here, waltz there. Oh, but it's been killed. It's glitched, so meaning it can't move its gun, turret, and it can't move its engine, so it's stuck there but can fire directly down here and glitched and can be repaired, so but still, very, very awkward. It can't do anything. It can be flanked, attacked, and all that time it was just staring death in the face for so long, pretty much. Yeah, it's just crazy. 99. Wow, nearly two capping the 1 point to go. They've taken back this point, Flapperjack for Omega CLS. Taking back the cap to the majority. 37, 99. Start ticking their favor. And they need it. They needed this Tiger up. Needs to be repaired extremely fast. And that was one of those moments where you just got to hit yourself. And yeah, if I was Liam right now, I'd be slapping myself. If Liam was Japanese, he would be doing it would be kamikaze right now. Just, what is he doing? What the hell did the Tiger take out that? It waltzed right in the path of the unrepairable tank. So many weird things are going on right here. M8's being pinged. Decent push from the Axis forces from Omega CLS. Going to come down to this area. Nat-Nat with the M8. Takes out the flak, gives way for the Rangers to potentially storm in. Flak has been shot at, still alive and repaired and undamaged. Miraculously. Lacking infantry though. Team Europe can really go in and attack that Southern Eastern and take that 1 point that they need to finish the game off. Bazooka being a bit stylish, trying to take out the M8 as well, but won't do so. M8 needs to be grenaded, can't be bazooka. I've never seen a bazooka kill M8 before. This guy has lost his ammunition, really needs to throw a grenade to finish it off, to be honest. Still repairable. Some reason, not throwing an AT grenade on it. Because he doesn't have any. Well, this guy should. I don't know. I question everything now. Are they doing things right? Did you... Did you lock the door before you leave home, Liam? I question that. Because you left the Sherman Fury alive for so long. You've been driving around it in circles. Definitely need to check that. Did you leave your keys? And you're going out? Did you leave your wallet on the train chair, Liam? I'm going a bit too far now. Joke has definitely expired. I pity my son, who will be punished or not punished. Never mind. Digging myself a grave in dead center, amongst the gravestones. I am. Nat 40mm is doing okay. Going to prevent Flapperjack from capping the flag back, and so soon they're out to victory, 9-47. They're going to be out to round two. Going to decide to get round three. Actually, not round three. This is round two. Yeah, round three. And they're going to meet the winner of Team North and 5D8. Flapperjack coming in to retake the point and stops the cap. 35 minutes, 99-47. What can they do? Just checking out my SMS. My food delivery is out. Since I am a bachelor now, basically my wife's overseas for a month or so I can have pizza. I can have any type of food, burger and chips, beer. Coming at 7 o'clock. Okay, still got plenty of time. Buffers in the center. Realm of the Beast has a lot of infantry there. I don't know how they can clear it out in time. 99-47. This target still being repaired could have been so instrumental in deciding the battle, taking out that Bofors, preventing any of this nonsense from happening in the start. And Liam. What's going on? Simons will definitely be livid right now. Oh, there you go, European gentleman through. And I'm going to put that down all to Liam. Liam and Simons should give them a good spank. Good game, guys. Omega CLS goes to the lower bracket. Hopefully Simons can get a game in the lower bracket, and we should see him again. European gentlemen, through to round three.